went down to Jerusalem to Jericho and fell among robbers, who stripped him and having wounded him went away, leaving him half dead. And the chance that a certain priest went down the same way, and seeing him passed by. In like manner also a Levite, when he was near the place and saw him, passed by. But a certain Samaritan, being on his journey, came near him, and seeing him, was moved with compassion. Going up to him, bound up the door of Christ at the church. Since it is your intention to enter the parish, join your right hand and declare your consent before God and the church.
I, Cormac, take you to town with my wife. I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health. I will love you and I will love you.
You have declared your consent before the church, and the Lord has good to strengthen your consent and fill you both with his blessing. For God's joy, man must not divide. Amen. May the Lord bless these rings which you give to each other as a sign of your love for the devil. May they be noted for their good lives and be parents filled with virtue.
in the last two.
Now it is.
The one accident with Roland is that if you're not sure what you're going to get, you don't know what you get on the movies.
Right?
Right. That's why I like movies.
Yeah, that is nice video, I tell you.
Mr. and Mrs. Thomas Monahan. The mother of the groom, Mrs. William Shea. Now we get into the young people, the bride upon themselves. We have Gail Monahan,
yes,
escorted by Michael Monahan. Our next couple, bridesmaid Cindy Cole and usher Gary Cole. Bridesmaid Nellie Shea, with her escort, Evan Shea. Sonny Monahan, escorted by Nikki Phillips. Our last bridesmaid and usher, we have Danny Monahan with Charlie Greenfall. And now we start getting serious, because we have our maid of honor and our best man. Ladies and gentlemen, our maid of honor, Virginia Monahan, with the best man, Clifford Rumpel. And now, in a few minutes, a second or two, be ready to stand up. As ladies and gentlemen, I present to you for the first time, in public, as husband and wife, Mr. and Mrs. Cormac Shea. We're going to the first dance. A song from about 20 years ago, a little bit more. A theme from a summer place. I would like to invite the rest of the bridal party, the parents of the bride, the parents of the groom. Please join in. Thank you. And one more time, a big hand for the whole bride party. At this time, I'd like to invite the bride party up to the table.
And she told me what I knew was true.
Boom, go. All right. That's Bernie Tamer.
Get up here, come on.
Number 23, yes. I'm going to play a little fanfare here and count. Is there any more? Zip. Okay, final countdown, folks. Oh, final countdown. One. Somebody's hand, but, okay, we're going to do it on the count of three again. One.
Two.
Two.
Three.
Three. Let it rip. The same guy catch it? What we gotta do is get the chair back on the floor. Get our throw the floor to the kid. And we got the garner. Now remember, Joe, you can send the jail on this one if you're not careful.
Both of you. Kelly, will you please stop calling me Mrs. Shea? Call me Joan. Practice it a few times. Say it now. Joan, 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 Joan. Not so hard.
Oh, thank you very much, Jane. Oh, here he is. Now, this man drinks beer and tomato juice.
Yes, this is Jack Eichhorst. I want to wish the best to Kelly and Cormac, and remember what the priest said at the chapel. Best of luck.
Thank you very much.